friends, today I'm going to take a new topic, that is earthquake. Now, what is an earthquake? An earthquake is trembling or shaking of the earth surface. The trembling or shaking of the earth surface is said to be earthquake. Now, why the trembling or shaking of the earth surface takes place? Because there is a plate inside the surface of the earth, and this plate used to vibrate. Because there is a plate inside the surface of the earth which used to vibrate. Now the question is, why this plate vibrate? The plate vibrates because there is a wave which is released at a point, and this point is called focus. There is a point within the surface of the earth, and that point is called focus. And at that point, what happens? There is a release of waves. There is a release of waves in all direction. When these waves strikes the plate, then plate is to vibrate. Now question is, why the generation of waves takes place? The generation of waves takes place because there is a release of energy inside the earth surface. Because there is a release of energy inside the earth surface because of some reasons, and this release of energy creates wave, and these waves, they used to disturb the plates. When plates are get disturbed, the jerking or shaking of the earth surface takes place. Now, what is a plate? For that, we have to know the internal structure of the earth. The internal structure of the earth if we move from this surface, from the surface, the first layer which we get, this is our first layer. If we move from the surface, this is what the first layer. And the first layer which we get is said to be crust. First layer is what? Crust. And below the crust, we get a layer which is called mantle. Below the crust, we get a layer which is called what? Mantle. And this mantle further divided into two layers. One is upper mantle, next one is lower mantle. So this is what? This is the mantle region. And the mantle region is divided into two layers. This is what? This layer is what? Upper mantle. And this layer is said to be what? Lower mantle. Now, the crust and the upper mantle together is said to be what? Plate. What is plate? Plate is what? Crust as well as upper mantle. The upper mantle and the crust is together is said to be what? Plate. Now, this plate used to move over a layer which is called asthenosphere. This plate used to move over a layer which is called asthenosphere. That means the asthenosphere is present just below the upper mantle. This region, we get a layer who which is called asthenosphere. Now, this asthenosphere is also said to be plasma, and it is also said to be semi-fluid region. It is also said to be semi-fluid region. Since it is semi-fluid, that's why it is also said to be fourth state of matter. Fourth state of matter. Other three states are solid, liquid and gas. Now question is, the plate is not a single plate. The plate, generally we get seven major plates, and 20 minor plates, and it is found that Pacific plate is the largest plate, which covers around 20% of total plates, and Zone de Fuca is the smallest plate. But both are remaining at the same place. That means these two are Pacific plate and Zone de Fuca are neighbors. Now what happens? These plates are always in motion. How they move against each other, I'm going to explain. Now how these plates are moving, and these plates may be continental or may be oceanic. Suppose this is continental plates, this is continental plates, this is continental plates, this is oceanic plates, this is oceanic plates. C for continental plates, O for oceanic plates. And these plates are moving in a layer which is called asthenosphere. So this layer is called what? Asthenosphere. Now, let us suppose this oceanic plate and this one both are moving against each other. That means both are moving away from each other. If two plates, they move away from each other, such type of margin is said to be divergent margin. If there are two plates, they are moving away from each other, such type of margin are said to be divergent margin. And if the divergent margin takes place between two oceanic plates, then the margin is also said to be constructive margin. Margin is also said to be constructive margin. If the divergent margin takes place between two oceanic plates, then such type of divergent margin are said to be constructive margin. Now, if there are two plates, suppose this is oceanic plates and this is continental plate. Both are coming and colliding like this. Both are coming towards each other. Then such type of margin is said to be convergent margin. Such type of margin are said to be convergent margin. And if the convergent margin takes place between one continental plate and other oceanic plates, then the convergent margin is said to be destructive margin. If the convergent margin takes place between one oceanic plate and one continental plate, such type of margin is also said to be what? Destructive margin. Now, if there are two plates which neither go away from each other, nor they come together. Neither they go away from each other, nor they come together and collide like this. But what they do, they will come and slide over another. That means they will neither go away from each other, nor they will come like this, but they will go by sliding over one another. Such type of margin is said to be what? Conservative margin. Conservative margin. Suppose this is continental plate, this is continental plate. Both are neither going like this nor moving away from each other, but sliding over one another. Such type of margin is said to be conservative margin. Now, what happens? See, this is suppose oceanic plate and this is what? Continental plate. What happens when they will come together? That means oceanic plate and the continental plate will come together. What will happen? The subduction of oceanic plates will take place. That means oceanic plate will go inside the continental plates. These oceanic plates will go below the continental plates. Because what happens? The oceanic plates, they are made up of basalt. And the continental plates, they are made up of granite. And both basalt and granites are igneous rocks. But basalt is heavier than granite. And we know the heavier substance always goes down. Since oceanic plate is made up of basalt, so it is more heavier. That's why when oceanic plate collides over what continental plates, then it always, oceanic plates always subduct or goes downwards. Now, when it goes downwards, what happens? As we already know, what we know? Suppose this is the what? Earth surface. This is what? Earth surface. When something moves downwards, the oceanic plate is moving like this downwards, dips. So when it is moving deep into the interior of the earth, it always what? Experience tremendous amount of heat. When something goes inside the earth, what happens? It always experiences heat. In the same way, when the oceanic crust will go inside the earth, what happens? It will experience tremendous heat. Why tremendous heat will experience? Because there are some radioactive decay and residual heat inside the surface of the earth. Because of radioactive decay and residual heat, this oceanic crust will experience what? Tremendous heat. As a result, this crust will form what? Magma. This crust will form magma because it will experience tremendous amount of heat, and this tremendous amount of heat is because of radioactive decay and residual heat. Now, when this will experience tremendous heat, what will happen? This oceanic crust will form what? Magma. Now, this magma will rotate. This magma will rotate inside. When this rotation of the magma takes place, there is a current generated which is called convective current. And sometimes what happens? This magma will come to fulfill the area which is vacated by these two oceanic plates. Because these two oceanic plates, what they are doing? They are moving away from each other. Since they are moving away from each other, what is happening? There is a vacancy. there is a vacancy which is created by these two oceanic plates. So this vacancy is fulfilled by this magma. This magma will come and it will fulfill the vacancy created by these two oceanic plates. Now sometimes what happens, this when they will come here, what will happen? They will create a jerking of the earth surface, or otherwise we can say it will cause an earthquake, and this earthquake is called Cello Foci earthquake. This earthquake is called Cello Foci earthquake. And sometimes what happens, this magma with a tremendous force, they will break the continental plates. They will break the continental plates and they will move out and thereby forming some mountain which are called volcanic mountain. These are called volcanic mountain. And such type of eruption of volcano is said to be central eruption type of volcano. Such type of volcano is said to be central eruption type of volcano. And this volcano used to jerk the surface of the earth or results what? Earthquake. This the responsible for the trembling or shaking of the earth or otherwise earthquakes takes place because of this volcanic mountain. And sometimes what happens, these two continental plates, what happens, they will neither move away from each other nor they will collide like this, but what they will do, they will just slide over each other. And when these two do like this, that means one slide over another like this, then there is a generation of earthquake. So these three reasons mainly. One is the magma when they come here to fulfill the vacated area, then this generates what? Earthquake. Another is when they form the volcanic mountain, there also they generate what? Earthquake. And when these two plates move by like this, they also generate what? Earthquake. Now in causes of earthquake, I already discussed volcanism and plate tectonics. Number three is construction of dams. What happens in dams? The water reservoir exerts a tremendous pressure onto the ground. These water reservoirs, what happens? They will exert tremendous pressure onto the ground, because of which the ground loses its elasticity. Since it exerts tremendous pressure, so because of which the ground loses its elasticity. Once it loses elasticity, then it results into earthquake. Number four is deep underground mining. Number five, blasting of rocks by dynamite. Number six, nuclear explosion. In India also, we did nuclear explosion in Pokhran. That also results for earthquake. Now landslides in rainy season, it occurs mainly in the rainy season. For example, in the hill areas, Arunachal, Tripura, in Assam also, the landslide is most prominent phenomenon. And this also leads to what? Earthquake. Now number 9 is injection of liquid waste into the ground. And this specially happens in the industrial area. What happens in industry? All the wastes, liquid materials will put inside the ground, and this also results what? Earthquake. And number 10 is what? Construction of high-rise building in a high-risk earthquake zone. High-risk earthquake zone, northeast. Northeast comes under high-risk earthquake zone. That means maximum damages can take place in the northeast regions, and it comes under fifth zone. Fifth zone means what? It is very high risk, that is very high earthquake prone area. So here, when we may construct a building, there it should not be many stories. There should have some limitation. Now I already mentioned the about the generation of wave. Now where these waves are generated? Suppose this is the point where the waves are generated. The point where the waves are generated is said to be what? Focus. So focus is the point where what? Waves is generating. Now from the focus, waves will move like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. Okay, so they will reach the surface of the earth. From the focus, they will what? Reach the surface of the earth. Now what happens? The point which is lying directly above the focus, the point, this point is lying directly above the focus. So this point is said to be epicenter, and it is the area nearby the epicenter where maximum destruction caused by the earthquake. That means where we see the maximum destruction, it is the point or it is the area nearby what? Epicenter. Since it is epicenter and this directly lies above the focus, and it is the point at the surface of the earth which is directly above the what? Focus. And that means if I say what? Focus is next to the, that means if we move from the surface, then the point which we get, that means the focus we get from here, if we move here, then we'll get what? Focus. So focus we get next after the what? Epicenter. That's why focus is said to be what? Hypocenter. Now when these waves will come and reach the surface, that means the first wave which reaches the surface of the earth, they are called what? Primary waves. So what are called primary waves? These are the first waves which reaches the earth's surface from the focus. They are called what? Primary waves. Now there is another wave which reaches next after the primary waves. There is another waves which reaches next after the primary waves, and these waves are called what? Secondary waves. That means secondary waves lags behind primary waves, and these two waves, they basically travels within the body, that they travels within the interior of the earth. That's why they are also called what? Body waves, since they travels within the body of the earth, so they are called what? Body waves. Now when these body waves, they react to the rocks present in the surface, when these body waves react to the rocks present in the surface, another type of wave is generated, and that wave is called what? Surface wave. If primary wave is the fastest wave, then surface wave is the most destructive wave, because the maximum damage caused or the maximum damage we can observe in an earthquake, it is by what? Surface wave. Now I will discuss little bit more about the primary waves, secondary waves, and the surface waves. discuss about primary waves, secondary waves and surface waves. Now, as I already discussed, primary wave is what? Fastest wave. This is what? Fastest wave. And surface wave is what? Surface wave is what? Is the most destructive. Is the most destructive wave. Now, second point is, primary wave is longitudinal. Primary wave is longitudinal. Secondary waves are transverse waves. Surface waves is also transverse wave. And longitudinal waves can be traveled in solids, liquid and in gas. But these transverse waves and these secondary waves or surface waves, since both are transverse, they can only travel in what? Solid. Now, what is longitudinal waves? I'm going to say. For that, we have to know what? Suppose the waves is traveling like this. Wave is traveling, longitudinal waves is traveling like this. Now, where these waves travels? These waves travels either in solids or in liquid or in gas. That means the waves which are traveling like this, they either will travel in solids, liquid or gas. The medium where the longitudinal waves is traveling is either solids or liquids or gas. These are three what? Mediums in which the longitudinal waves are moving. Now, these solids, suppose solids, liquids or gas, suppose I am taking here, these are solids. Suppose I can take liquid also, I can take gas also, because it can travel in all three. But I am taking what? Solids. Suppose longitudinal waves is traveling like this, and solids also, suppose traveling like this. Solids means the medium where this wave is traveling. That means the medium is what? Material. The material where these waves are moving. Suppose this material is solid. This longitudinal wave is moving like this. The material of the medium is also moving like this. But after few microseconds, it will move. It will return. That means it will reverse its direction. The material wave, that means the material will reverse its direction. What happens? Suppose this is the solid material, this is wave. Wave is moving. And wave is moving in suppose solid. The solid is also moving in the same direction. But what happens after few microseconds, it will reverse its direction. Thereby, it is forming compressions and rarefactions. When it is moving, when the material is moving along with the direction of wave, what is happening? It is forming compressions. Now, after few microseconds, it will reverse its direction. Thereby, it will form what? Rarefactions. Or in layman terms, compression means what? When it will move along with the direction of wave, when the solid material or maybe liquid or gas, when it will move along with the direction of wave, then what happens? The density of the material at this point will become maximum. So max, high density. And when it will reverse its direction, then it will make the region lower density. That means what happens? If these waves created high density region and low density region. That is, it creates, these waves create difference in densities. This is also said to be what? Pulling and pushing wave. Pull or push wave. Because pull means it will go like this, the material of the medium will go like this, again it will reverse like this. So this is also said to be what? Pull or push wave. And the transverse waves. In the transverse waves, what happens? Suppose the wave is moving like this. Here, the medium of the material, and here medium of the material is only solid. The medium of the material will move ups and down. It will move like this. It will move like this. Here it was moving to and fro. Here it is moving like this. Like this means the material of the medium. You can say the material of the medium in transverse waves is moving perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave. That means here material of the medium move like this. Like this. So by this, here also it will move like this. Material of the medium will move like this. This is our direction of propagation of wave. So if we feel the wave like this, if you feel the wave like this, then you can say this is what? Primary waves. If you feel the waves like this, then you can say this is what? Surface or secondary waves. Now I discussed about the primary waves, secondary waves and surface waves. Now these three will be recorded in an instrument which is called seismograph. Seismograph is the instrument where the primary, secondary and surface waves will be recorded. Now, what happens? There are some portions in the interior of the earth where seismograph cannot detect the waves. The seismograph cannot detect the waves inside the interior of the earth in some portion. And those portions where seismograph cannot detect the waves, the region is called seismic shadow zone. And seismic shadow zone for primary waves is 103 to 142. That means in this portion, we cannot see, seismograph cannot detect what? Waves. Why? And what happens? This, have you seen this curve part? And this curve part what? Because of refraction of waves. And this refraction of waves is not needed in geography, but if you know the only what diagram, that's enough. Refraction, as you have studied in lower class, refraction of light when it moves from rare medium to denser medium, then it moves towards the normal, and when it moves from denser to rare, it moves away from the normal. That is all the process happening here. So these, all these things are not needed in geography. Now if we move this towards this secondary wave, here what happens? In secondary waves, the seismic shadow zone is more. It is from here to here. Here seismic shadow zone is more. Now why seismic shadow zone is more? For that you have to know one more thing. What is that thing? The core. Actually, core, if I move core now, core is divided into two layers. One is outer core and another is, this is outer core, this is what? Inner core. And this outer core is actually liquid. The outer core is what? Liquid. Inner core is what? Solid. That's what happened. I already told These waves, secondary waves, cannot travel in liquid. It only travels in what? Solid. So here liquid are present, that's why we cannot detect any waves here. The waves cannot pass through here. That's why in secondary waves, we get more shadow zones. Now, I already discussed what in earthquake we heard often that its magnitude and intensity. Now, what actually magnitude is and what intensity is? For that, we have to know few concepts. Magnitude of earthquake and intensity of earthquake. Now, magnitude is nothing but amount of energy released in an earthquake. Amount of energy released in an earthquake is called what? Magnitude. Now, what is intensity then? Intensity is what? The maximum amount of damage. The amount of damage that we can observe. The damage which we can observe is measured by what? Intensity. And magnitude is actually basically measured by Richter scale. It is what? Richter scale. And intensity is basically what? Measured by Markelli scale. Markelli scale. Nowadays, it is also said, nowadays, geologists used to use modified Markelli scale. It is what the intensity is nothing but the amount of damage that can be we can observe in an earthquake. And suppose we consider, suppose there is a place called A, there is a place called B. Suppose magnitude of A is 6, B also 6. But what happens is the crust of A is weaker than that of B. And also at the same time, A is densely populated. Densely populated. That means what happened? A's crust is weaker crust. And also A is what? Densely populated. And what happened? Magnitude of A is 6. Magnitude of B is also 6. But B is not densely populated, as well as crust of the B is stronger than A. Then what we can observe? Intensity of A is more than intensity of B. Why? Because intensity of A is more than B because crust of A is weaker, at the same time it is densely populated. Because of these two reasons, we can see more damage in A. Now, one more thing we have to know, that is what? Isosismal line. What happens? Suppose this is the point, this point energy release takes place, so this point is called what? Focus. So waves will be generated like this. Suppose this is the place A, this is the place B, this is the place C, this is the place D, this is the place E, this is the place F. If we join this A, B, C, D, E, F, what we can observe? intensity of A is same, intensity of B is same, C is same, D is same, E is same, F is same. That means intensity of A, B, C, D, E, F is same. So the line joining the same intensity point is called what? Isosceles line.